Charlie Mordecai is of the aristocracy, and there's a sort of, in a lot of cases, the aristocracy end up with these wonderful, huge mansions, from the 14th century, and with tons of acreage and stuff like that. Well, they can't afford that house like that, to heat it, to this, to that, to whatever. So Mordecai's aristocracy is intact. However, his bank book is just worn out. If the characters know it's funny, you're dead. It's over with. So bringing this to the screen with the likes of Gwyneth Paltrow and Ewan McGregor, Paul Bettany, Johnny P, as I was saying, Olivia Munn, who was brilliant in the film as Georgina. Yeah, it all these characters sort of, it's like this, everything's coming together where they will eventually collide. Paul Bettany, who is truly one of the funniest human beings I've ever met and one of the smartest, was the only, I mean, from the time I read that screenplay, he was the only person I could, I, that, who could play Jock in my eyes, properly. And, Bettany's not, known necessarily within the industry as a comedic actor, even though he's really funny. And so in Mordecai, it's Bettany's, I mean, it's a lot of Bettany in there that just cracks you up, just kills you. When his wife Joanna is away on vacation, she hears about their imminent financial ruin. So she cuts her trip short, comes back, finds her husband Charlie with this thing on his lip that he'd grown. And she despises it and demands that he cut it off, shave the mustache, and he just can't do it. He just can't do it. It is a point of, it's his dignity, it's his place in the world. It goes back in the Mordecai family, and that sort of aristocratic, sort of Lord Mordecai, this, that, so his mustache, for him, is a point of pride, is a point of, he feels complete with the mustache.